हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑल फोर्स ई लर्निंग जूनियर इंटरमीडिएट इंग्लिश क्लास। आई एम वेरी मच एक्साइटेड टू कंटिन्यू माय सेशन। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन आई स्टार्टेड द लेसन फ्रॉम फोर्थ मॉड्यूल, दैट इज स्पोकन इंग्लिश एंड ब्रोकन इंग्लिश। एज देयर इज ग्लोबलाइजेशन, पीपल हैव अपॉर्चुनिटीज ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड। They will have to fly off to search for the opportunities. What is the common language used all over the world? One can say that is English. Many people belong to different areas because of lack of skills in English. They are not willing to go abroad, though they have opportunities. My dear students, you please remember, any language you take, no two persons speak alike. There will be variation in expression. Therefore, one need not worry to speak English. Develop that habit. Okay, so that's what we discussed a part of the lesson yesterday. Our author was one of the members of the committee which was designed by the British Broadcasting Corporation to test and analyze the skills of those employees of BBC. There were different members from Scotland, members from Ireland, members from America, and members from England. Intellectuals, when they come to one place, obviously they cannot come to a proper conclusion. They do not agree with the expression of the simplest and commonest words we generally use. They are yes and no. One person says in one way and that is not accepted by another person, he says in another way. Who is to be taken as the role model? That's a big question the author also reveals, and he also says that he should be taken as a role model as he is an Irishman. Okay, let me continue the next part of the lesson. My dear young students, please pay attention. If you have the textbook with you, please open and follow. Okay, I have said enough to you about the fact that no two native speakers of English speak it alike, but perhaps you are clever enough to ask me whether I myself speak it in the same way. I have already told you that no two English speakers speak alike. As you are very clever enough to say that, can you say I eventually or naturally say that no. I also do not speak similarly. My expressions vary at different places according to the situation. That's what I'm going to explain you now. I must confess at once that I do not. I must admit the fact that I do not. I also do not speak alike. I also do not speak similarly. It varies. How does it vary? You see here. I am at present speaking to an audience of many thousands of gramophonists, many of whom are trying hard to follow words syllable by syllable. At present, what am I doing? The author says, I am addressing thousands of people who have gathered here. They have gramophones and they can be able to listen to my lecture and they can be able to listen each and every syllable. Syllable is the smallest independent sound unit of any language. They carefully observe my utterances. They carefully observe my disclosures, that means my words, very consciously. So, I should be very careful when I speak to you people while I address you. Okay, if I were to speak to you as carelessly as I speak to my wife at home, this record would be useless. If I speak to you as carelessly as I speak to my wife at home, it will be absurd. This record becomes useless, futile waste. And you remember, dear students, please carefully observe. And if I were to speak to my wife at home as carefully as I am speaking to you, she would think that I was going mad. As carefully as I am speaking to you, if I speak to my wife, naturally, my wife comes to a conclusion that I have become mad. So we speak very freely at home. Very humorously we speak. Practically, it is not possible to express. But in the classroom, we can practically explain all these things. We can speak very freely to our family members. Here, the author has expressed only the wife. As I speak to my wife, in the same way, if I speak to you, how do you feel? That doesn't seem good. And if I speak to my wife, as I speak to you, she feels that I have become mad. I need not be so much conscious when I speak to my wife, but I must be very conscious when I speak to the gathering. When we speak to people outside, we should be very careful. That means there will be a variation in our diction. That means the manner of speaking. Okay, dear students, please remember that. Next, as a public speaker, I have to take care that every word I say is heard distinctly at the far end of large halls containing thousands of people. I am a public speaker. As I am a public speaker, when I address the gathering or the people, every word of mine is distinctly heard, is clearly heard by all the people who listen to my lecture. And you see here, though they are at the far end of the lecture halls, and that hall contains thousands of people listen to the words delivered by me very, very, very clearly. That means how much conscious I should be, you can imagine. When I have to consider only my wife sitting within 6 feet of me at breakfast, I take so little pains with my speech that very often instead of giving me the expected answer, she says, "Don't mumble and don't turn your head away when you speak." So when I speak to my wife at home, who is just opposite to me on the other side of the table, I speak to her very slowly. For example, just serve me to it. Serve me to Italy, like that if I speak. I need not be so conscious when I speak to her. I need not express respectable words. Just out of affection I can speak very closely. And when I speak like that, the distance is very less. Very near to me she sits. And then she says, "Don't mumble, speak clearly." Mumble means speak indistinctly. She says like that. And she also says, "Don't turn away your head when you speak." Okay. I can't hear a word you are saying. What are you speaking? I'm not able to listen to you. We don't shout at home. And when I speak or when I address the gathering, I cannot speak slowly. I need not shout at home. I speak slowly. But when I speak slowly to the people outside in a gathering, that is not heard properly. I can't hear a word you are saying. And she also is a little careless. She will be very careless. But when people outside, when they listen to our lecture, they are very careful. At home, we are very casual. We have casual utterances at home. Okay, dear students, you see, sometimes I have to say, "What?" She says something. I ask her, "What have you said? What have you said?" I ask. 2 or 3 times during our meal, she speaks slowly. And I ask her, "What do you mean? What are you saying?" Like that I ask. And she suspects me of growing deafer and deafer, though she does not say so. And she suspects me that I have become deaf. This fellow, old fellow, he is not able to hear. She won't express that. That may be her inner feeling. A wife does not use such word. "Have you become deaf?" Can a wife say to her husband? No. Okay, and here you see, does not say so because as I am now over 70, it might be true. I am over 70. It might be true. I might have become deaf because of my age. So that's what the author humorously expresses. Okay, dear students, you see here. No doubt I ought to speak to my wife as carefully as I should speak to a queen. There is no doubt at all. I ought to speak to my wife as carefully as I speak to a queen. As I speak to our boss, for example, I should speak to my wife also. And in the same way, and she to me as carefully as she would speak to a king. We ought to, but we don't. And she should speak to me as carefully as she speaks to the king. We ought to speak like that, but we don't. We do not speak. Why don't we speak? We are habituated to speak very casually at home. Can we speak to our boss as we speak to our family members? And as we speak to our boss, can we speak to our family members? The diction or the way of speaking definitely varies. Dear students, please try to understand. We all have company manners and home manners. You know, we all have manners. Company manners and home manners. Our behavior differs. We are at home, for instance, our behavior is in one way. And when we come to our workplace, our behavior varies. Okay, if you were to call on a strange family, who are not known to you, or a different family, and to listen through the keyhole, you know, keyhole, just when we open the lock with a key, there is a hole. Through that hole, you observe. In fact, that is not right. That is not correct. That's what author here says. Just observe. Not that I would suggest for a moment that you are capable of doing such a very unladylike or ungentlemanlike thing. Unladylike or ungentlemanlike thing to do that. It is absurd, it is unreasonable, it is in fact and indeed not good. But for the sake of what? Just for the sake of knowing the difference in expressions, you can watch. That's what he's saying. Here you see. But still, if in enthusiasm for studying languages, you could bring yourself to do it just for a few seconds to hear how a family speak to one another when there is nobody else listening to them, and then walk into the room and hear how very differently they speak in your presence, the change would surprise you. But just for the sake of understanding, but just for the sake of knowing what is going to happen there, just for the sake of understanding the change in diction or manner of speaking, how they exchange their views, one another, or if there are only two persons, if they exchange their views each other, in the presence of you, suppose they are speaking, When they feel that there is nobody, they speak very freely, wife and husband. They use affectionate words. It's a secret we cannot reveal even. And when a person suddenly enters the room, you can easily identify or you can easily find the difference in their expression. So that's what the author clearly says here. Their expressions, their words also, the whatever the words they use, they change. As the author, when he addressed the public gathering, the words are heard very distinctly, therefore he is very conscious, but he is not that much conscious when he speaks to his wife. It's a general experience, everybody will have that. So here also it is clearly revealed. My dear students, you just observe, even that will definitely surprise you. We can give practical exams, practical examples in the classroom. Okay, even when our home manners are as good as our company manners, even when our home manners are as good as company manners, and of course they ought to be much better, they are always different. Here the author clearly says that home manners and company manners, they are as good, home manners are as good as company manners, and he also says that home manners are much better than company manners. That means he clearly says that even at home, when we speak to our family members, we should speak well, but that will be different. How you see here? And the difference is greater in speech than in anything else. We can easily find the difference, and the difference is especially in speech. Author clearly says that we should speak well even at home, but we don't. We can easily find the difference. That manners is different, especially in speech. Okay, just one more paragraph, my dear students. Suppose I forget to wind my watch. My watch is not working. I have not given it for repair. Okay. And of course, it is stopped and it does not work. I have to ask somebody to tell me the time. I have to ask somebody, what is the time now? When the person is a stranger, how do we express? Here he says, if I ask a stranger, I say, what o'clock is it? Could you tell me what is the time now? We express very clearly, or we ask very politely. Okay. The stranger hears every syllable distinctly. Every part of the word he can hear clearly. Distinctly means clearly. But if I ask my wife, all she hears is clocks. When I want to ask my wife, just simply I ask, time, we can speak loudly. We don't ask our family members, or if I ask my wife, for instance, let me say, my dear wife, could you tell me, I will be very much thankful to you if you please tell me what the time is now. She obviously feels that something has happened to me. I have become a mad fellow. Okay, so very casually we ask when we speak to our family members or wife. Okay, this is good enough for her, but it would not be good enough for you. It would be good enough for my wife, but it would not be good enough for you. The people who are in front of me, who are listening to my words, I must be very conscious when I speak to you, because each and every syllable of words can be listened carefully by all. So I should be conscious. So many instances the author uses. Many instances are there in this lesson. How the speech varies, how the utterances vary when we speak at different places. Okay, dear students. So I am speaking to you now much more carefully than I speak to her, but please don't tell her. So he is saying, I am speaking to you more carefully than I speak to her. Again, the author humorously says that please don't tell her. She may feel, just casually he says, okay, my dear young students, please try to understand. So you try to speak, that's it. You have to develop that habit. If you develop, automatically you can become perfect. Okay, dear students, I am now going to address myself, especially to my foreign hearers. My dear people, I am now going to address myself to the people who have gathered here. Just you pay attention. I have to give them another warning of quite a different kind. I would like to give them a warning. Of course, that's a different kind of warning. If you are learning English because you intend to travel in England and wish to be understood there, if you are learning English, as you are willing to go to England, as you are willing to speak English to the English, and that should be understood by them there in England, do not try to speak English perfectly. Because if you do, no one will understand you. Do not try to speak perfect English. Even the mother tongue is English. When you go to England, you speak in English. Don't worry about perfect English. If you speak English perfectly, even the English people do not understand. What is this, sir? Suppose in Telugu, సంధ్యాకాలం సమయములో మా గృహమునకు విచ్చేసి తేనీరు సేవించెదరా మీరు. కెన్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్? ఇఫ్ ఐ సే లైక్ దట్, సాయంత్రం వచ్చి మా ఇంట్లో చాదాగు, ఇట్ కెన్ బి ఈజీలీ అండర్స్టూడ్. ఇంగ్లీష్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో సేమ్. వెన్ వీ యూజ్ కామన్ లాంగ్వేజ్ విచ్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ బై ద పీపుల్ డైలీ, ఇన్ దట్ డిక్షన్ ఇఫ్ యూ స్పీక్ దే కెన్ ఈజీలీ అండర్స్టాండ్. యూ నీడ్ నాట్ స్పీక్ ఎనీ లాంగ్వేజ్ పర్ఫెక్ట్లీ టు మేక్ అదర్స్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ యూ స్పీక్. లెర్నింగ్ ఇంగ్లీష్ ఈజ్ డిఫరెంట్ విత్ గ్రామర్, దట్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్ మ్యాటర్. యూ కెన్ మేక్ ఏ వండర్ఫుల్ స్పీచ్, దట్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్. బట్ వెన్ యూ స్పీక్ టు ద పీపుల్ దేర్, ఈవెన్ దో దే ఆర్ ఇంగ్లీష్ పీపుల్, యూ కెన్ స్పీక్ ఇంగ్లీష్ నార్మల్లీ ఓన్లీ. యూ నీడ్ నాట్ వరీ దట్ యూ డోంట్ నో ఇంగ్లీష్. వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇంగ్లీష్ యూ నో యూ స్పీక్, దే విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్. ఐ నాట్ కేమ్ టు కాలేజ్ ఎస్టర్డే, ఐ కేమ్ నాట్ టు కాలేజ్ ఎస్టర్డే, మీనింగ్ ఈజ్ కన్వేడ్. దెర్ ఈస్ నో గ్రామర్ ఇన్ ఇట్, ఇట్ ఈస్ యూజ్లెస్, ఇట్ ఈస్ మీనింగ్లెస్, బట్ మీనింగ్ ఈజ్ కన్వేడ్, దట్ కెన్ బి అండర్స్టూడ్. ఇన్ దట్ వే యూ కెన్ గెట్ పర్ఫెక్షన్ ఇన్ స్పీకింగ్. ఓకే డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, సో వీ విల్ కంటిన్యూ ద రిమైనింగ్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద లెసన్ టుమారో. సో ఇట్ టేక్స్ ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ 3 సెషన్స్ టు కంప్లీట్ ద లెసన్, బికాస్ ఇట్ ఈస్ పర్టైనింగ్ టు ఇంగ్లీష్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు లర్న్ ఇంగ్లీష్, యూ డోంట్ వరీ టు స్పీక్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్, డెవలప్ ది హ్యాబిట్ కంపల్సరీలీ, యూ కెన్ బికమ్ పర్ఫెక్ట్. విత్ దిస్ ఐ ఎండ్ ద సెషన్. డియర్ స్టూడెంట్స్, ఐ ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ థ్యాంక్స్ ఫర్ లిజనింగ్ టు మై లెక్చర్. యూ విల్ కంటిన్యూ ద రిమైనింగ్ టుమారో. థ్యాంక్ యూ.